Hello everyone, thanks for joining us for the Skipjack Open. I'm Luke Elby, it's great to have your company. Alongside me is my partner in crime, John McCarthy. It's time to get our final round action underway.
Thanks, Luke. Our next golfer on the tee had a, I would categorize it in the okay category. Hopefully they can do a little bit more on the course today.
Well, things can change in an instant, John, and if they can just catch a feel, maybe they can deliver one of their better rounds.
Thanks, Luke. We'll chat after nine holes and compare notes. And let's see if he can continue with his stellar play here today. And I think he'll like that from 115 yards out. It's about a few feet from the cup. And starting the round off with a par, not bad. And now the second hole tee off. Just launched this drive. And hitting from 195 yards out. And this putt's for birdie. And that one's right in the cup. And our leader today currently has a round of 8 under. And next up is a par 4, folks. probably not too pleased with his performance there.
Okay, I'm setting up here in the rough.
And I think he will like that.
And this putt is for birdie. And this putt's for par. And after that hole, one under for the day. And teeing off on this next hole, the wind could come into play. Let's find out. And a promising looking shot here.
Pretty sure he's gonna like that one.
This putt's right around a 9-footer. Oh my lands, that was very close. And about 6 feet to go here.
Finishing this hole with a solid putt.
And that performance has led him to go down in the standings. Okay, let's see what the fifth has in store today. And now back into the fairway from 140 yards out. This is heading towards the green. This one's about 11 feet from the cup.
Oh, that was so close.
And for the par. And currently sitting at one under for the day. And teeing off on this par three. Here's the 3-wood. I think he'll be happy with that. This putt's for birdie. Very nicely done. Long putt right into the cup. And he will move up on the leaderboard after that hole. And let's see what the 7th hole has in store today. It appears to be heading for the fairway here. And this next shot is from above the hole. That looks like a 5-iron. And I am pretty sure he's gonna like that. This is looking like 17 feet from here. Oh, that was close. And tapping in for par. And currently our leader is sitting on top of things here with a round of 10 under. And now setting up for the par 4 tee off. This one's looking pretty good. This one's a close call. This could be in the rough. Ooh, and it just doesn't drop. And this to save par. Solid putt. And after that one, 2 under for the day. And now getting ready to tee off on this par 3. I think that's a 5-iron. And that one's going to miss the green. Just too much club. Now let's take a look and see what's happening up on that leaderboard. And after 9, we're checking back in with our guy, Luke. What are you seeing out there on the course today as we finish up this final round of action?
Oh, everyone loves a big back 9 surge, John. And this one's got it written all over it. He's 5 back. I hope he can pull it out.
Thanks, Luke. Well, I'm pretty sure this is going to land in the fairway here. And about 2:15 to the pin. Going with the 4-iron here. Fantastic work on this par 5, hitting the green in 2. And the putt drops for eagle. And as we look at the board, our leader is currently sitting at 9 under. Okay, now moving on to the 11th. Ooh, look at that drive go. Okay, about 165 yards to the pin. And he will like that. And about 4 feet from the cup. And that one will go for birdie. And he is moving up on the leaderboard after that hole. And now setting up for the next par 4 hole. Yeah, it's looking like this is bound for the short stuff. And about 185 yards to the pin. going with the 4-iron here. This is going towards the green here. And this putt's for birdie. This shot is looking too good. And about 5 feet from the cup. And the par putt drops. And after that one, 5 under par for the day. And he's also tied for 7th place up on the leaderboard. All right, let's see what happens on the 13th hole here. And I think he's gonna like that.
From here, it's about 10 feet away.
Ooh.
And this for the par.
And finishing the hole with a solid putt.
And he's going to stay right there where he was on the leaderboard. No change in the ranking. And now teeing off on the par 3 hole.
And with that, he's on the green.
And this one's for birdie.
Nice little putt. And 6 under par on the day after that hole.
And he's currently tied for 4th up on the leaderboard.
Well, you'll probably like that. Well, this is a tough call. Could be rough, could be fairway. Very well played golf shot. Hitting this par 5 and 2, it's going to set up some serious possibilities. 31 feet to the cup. Oh my goodness. This one's about 3 feet away. And he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard after that hole. And setting up on the 16th tee. Going with the 8-iron. And some unfortunate luck there on that approach shot. Unfortunately, not enough club on that one. And with this, hopefully, they can save par. And that putt will drop. And after that hole, staying right there in fourth place. And now teeing off on this par four. Well, I'm not quite sure where this one's going to end up. This one looks about 4 feet. And that one drops for the bogey. And it looks like he moved down on the leaderboard after that one. And as he tees off here on the 18th hole, he's only 3 strokes off the lead. Let's see what happens. Pretty sure that's the 5-wood. And I think the 5-wood is a bit too much for this one.
And that beauty little sand shot is going to put par very much on the table. And that putt drops for par.
And Luke, as this round comes to an end, I think he's left himself in pretty good shape on that leaderboard.
They had a few chances there to get the win, but ultimately a top 10 is not to be sneezed at. They should be happy with that. On behalf of our hard-working production crew and all the team in the truck, I'm Luke Elvey, saying so long for now.